lockdowns. Not good. Okay, here's the Clinton one. A lot of sharers sharing this one this week. Let's take a look here. Hillary Clinton passing Dr. Fauci a note in class, and it says, you should have deleted the emails. A little friendly advice there from Hillary Clinton to Dr. Fauci. As we say, teamwork makes the meme work, or memes work, I should say. Let's welcome in our meme team. Stacy on the right, Stacy Washington checking in. Erin Elmore Esquire, a Republican strategist and a couture meme enthusiast. And last, but first in the hearts of fact checkers, Seth Dillon from the Babylon Bee. Great to see you all. Here, there it is. Very nice. You can see the semblance. Very creative memers out there. Erin, but let's go to your meme now. Not exactly a meme, more of a tweet, right? And
right.
This
well,
is... go ahead.
Yeah, sorry about that. I took this one really personally because for anyone that attacked me, told me I deserved to die, or called me a grandma killer, I take apologies in the form of cash or Chick-fil-A, but substitute for me Chick-fil-A, champagne, or shoes, or dresses. Because we were lambasted as conservatives. We were tortured as conservatives. We were called names as conservatives. And now we find out that no, we are not tinfoil hat crazies. We are absolutely accurate, and we were right the whole time. This was not a conspiracy theory. Masks really do not work the way that we were told to. And then when Fauci went on to say not one mask, two masks, and perhaps even wear goggles when he knew all along that masks didn't work. I found that to be really upsetting and really troubling.
Well, when we all get our cut of the $10 trillion reparation check from China, Erin, we'll be getting champagne, Gucci shoes, and Chick-fil-A. All right, Seth, let's go to you now. Here you go. Dr. Fauci gets in heated debate with himself and 17 previous versions of himself.
And the media keeps propping him up, you know, to Erin's point. Conservatives have been treated as conspiracy theorists who have now been basically proven right by these emails.
And the persistence and virality of your enemies. Yep. And when you have major mainstream newspapers attacking you, Seth, you're over the target. Kudos. We love what you do. Everyone in America, even leftists, are laughing and enjoying your work. That's high praise.
Yeah. And I think, Stacey, you said it so well, because I think so many of us, too, Erin, have this like visceral reaction when we see these things from Seth, and you see how it just skewers, especially when it comes to the fake news aspect of it. And that's why it is so important.
It is so important. And your weekend Newsmax host, Benny Johnson, has a saying, which is the left can't meme. What is upsetting to them here, I believe, is that we have gotten funnier than they. We have produced better memes than they. And I do think that Seth should pursue legal action here, because he has developed and cultivated a brand. And that brand has a financial value. And if the New York Times can just go around slandering him and defaming him, that hurts his brand and the business that he's worked so hard to cultivate and create. And this isn't just about accountability. This is about capitalism and a democracy. And he has every right to protect his business. And we can't just have major newspapers and publications saying things that are false about us and hurting everything that we work for every day. So I believe that just like Nick Sandman, that young gentleman wearing the MAGA hat, won the lawsuit against CNN, I see the Babylon Bee winning a big lawsuit against the New York Times.
Well, Seth, what did you think when you see guys like Jonathan Carl this week and Glenn Kessler from the Washington Post, the fact checker over there, being like, yeah, I mean, President Trump said it came from the Wuhan lab, but, you know, nobody listened to him because it was President Trump. I the lack of contrition coming from some of these members of the media, too, I think is still kind of jarring at this point.
It is jarring. It's still a huge blind spot for them, isn't it? They don't realize just exactly how committed they are to their narrative.
And by, we'll see in about an hour or so. Also, it's never too late. A 94-year-old woman in Alabama is living proof of that. We'll have that story and much more. Your catch-up is next. For round two of the mean team, a double dose this week. Another person having a pretty rough go of it this week, Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. She's come under fire for sharing pictures of her grandma's collapsed house in Puerto Rico. And, of course, social media, never missing a moment. They were quick to bring up the heat and asked why AOC's abuela, as she calls her, lives in those conditions while she is driving a brand new Tesla, living in a high-rise luxury apartment in Washington, D.C., and, of course, making that $175,000 a year salary from U.S. taxpayers like you and me. Of course, the memes came pouring in after her assessment of her abuela's house in Puerto Rico. Here's this one. It has a picture of AOC, a cartoon with stacks of cash and coins, and you know, an old woman who is obviously struggling in Puerto Rico. Please help me with my home. It's collapsing and I can't pay rent. And AOC says, I'm sorry, Trump didn't help you. Special AOC edition with us, host of Stacey on the right on Sirius XM. It is the woman herself, Stacey Washington. Erin Elmore is also here. Erin Elmore Esquire, E Squared, Republican strategist. And Seth Dillon, the CEO of the Babylon Bee. Guys, thanks for sticking around. All right, let's talk about our AOC memes here. What do you got for us, Stacey?
Well, the Bible says if you don't care for the members of your own family, you're worse than an infidel.
Meme here. What do you got for us, Erin?
Little play on words here. All the bad weather is Trump's fault because he pulled out of the Honda Accord. This is just a play on how Alessandra, well, let's call her Sandy Cortez, because that's what her real name was until about 2 years ago. Sandy just says anything. And if it's anyone's fault, Trump. Trump, Trump, you're racist. Trump, 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 you're racist. So this is just how her plan works. So she never says anything that's really logical or actual or factual. You know, if you want to stop having criminals, stop building jails, she said this week. These things are not grounded in fact, not grounded in reality. She just talks. Let's make AOC bartend again. I think that's where she belongs. We need her to stop being an elected official. I just want to meet some of the people that voted for her. I just want to be like, okay, who are you? Why did you think she was qualified? Why are you voting for this woman? Of course, I feel badly for her grandmother, but I think Stacey said all there is to say, you take care of your family.
Yeah, well, they made a whole documentary about how great she was before she even got into office. And, you know, she's riding the coattails of that. So, Seth, let's give us your meme here. One more meme.
AOC claims her abuela died in attack on Capitol. Now, you know, she's such a drama queen, isn't she? Do you remember how she was responding to the Capitol situation there, where she talked about being
PTSD.
Traumatized?
Our jails. The answer is to stop building more of them. The answer is to make sure that we actually build more hospitals. Mm-hmm. We pay organizers. We get people mental health care and overall health care, employment, etc. It's to support communities, not throw them away.
To you, Erin, and to you, Seth, real quickly, thought bubbles for Jamal Bowman and Chuck Schumer there.
Oh, gosh, I can't even think what they're thinking. I think they're rolling their eyes and just wishing they had another Starbucks. But I agree with Stacey completely. Mental health is a major problem in this country. And instead of working to help these people, they say, oh, they deserve to live on the streets. They can steal up to $1,000 a day. And all that does is create a vicious cycle where people aren't getting treatment. When people go to jail for stealing, they do get drug counseling in jail. They do get mental health treatment in jail. And sometimes this actually works to rehabilitate people and get them off the streets into proper housing and proper health care and proper mental health care. So I do believe that the Democrats have created a problem that's far worse than it used to be. If you just look at what's going on in California, they're the paradigm for this. Mm-hmm. It's truly horrible. And yet now they see that it is a problem and they deny and refuse to acknowledge their place in any of it. So truthfully, I'm glad that she is speaking up about mental health. I just wish they realized that she was part of the problem for creating it.
All right, guys, we got to leave it there. Unfortunately, we are out of time. Seth, thanks so much. Great to see you as always. Stacey and Erin, we'll see you guys very soon.